above S cube minus 27 all over what? X minus 3. From here, are you going to use direct substitution? No, we can't use direct substitution. We only have a numerator and a denominator. And if you can see from here, you can also see that we can factorize out. Whenever you have a problem like this, please concentrate on trying to what? Eliminate the denominator if it's possible, or what? Simplify it. Now, for example, let me say I use direct substitution here. If I use direct substitution under this question, it will give me what? Using direct substitution, you have 3q minus 27 all over what? 3 minus 3. And 3 cubed is what? 27 minus 27 all over what? 0. So this is 0,0. So you can see that direct substitution will give us 0,0, which is undefined. But what we are interested in is we want to what? Simplify it. You can see that from this value that this is what? Factorizable. Let me give you a formula where you have a what? A factorized whisper of 3, how to factorize it. You can just simply, the formula is very easy. All you have to do is, for example, you have a cube minus b cube, right? So it's going to give you a minus b into what? A square plus what? A b plus b square. That's the formula you're going to use to what? Factorize something that is equal to what? 3. Now, from this question, you can see that our a is what? X. My b is what? 3 squared, right? Yes, so my b is 3. Because 3 raised to the power of 3 will give us what? 27. Right? Good. So, for me to put it under this side, it's going to give me x minus 3 all into what? X squared plus 3x plus what? 9. Right? So I've already succeeded in what? Factorizing this. Look at, I gave you the formula. So what I just did is what? I inserted what? The values. So divided by what? X minus 3. Right? So from here you can see that this will cancel this. Please do not forget we are solving under what? Limit of what? 3. So this is still in limit of x is what? Equals to what? 3. Right? So once we cancel out, we'll be left with this. So once we cancel out, we'll be left with this. So what we're going to be left with is what? Limit of what? X is equal to what? 3. And then we'll be left with this quadratic, which is 3x plus 9. Remember, once it's like this, we can what? Now do direct what? Substitution. So under this, we have what? Our x is 3, so this is what? 3 squared plus 3 into 3 plus what? 9. So this is 9 plus 9 plus 9, which is equal to what? 27. Are you with me? Good. Now let's go on to a little bit of some hard stuff. Now, under example number four, what if you have something like this? Limit of s is equal to 4, and then you have 1 all over root of x minus 1 all over 2 divided by x minus 4. So if you have something like this, listen, we have a rule to solve something like this. But before I proceed to solve something like this, I would like to introduce this stuff. You can see that this is a complex number and it contains what? Fraction. Whenever you have a complex number and you have a fraction attached to it, there is a number of laws you need to follow. Rule number one, we have to what? Multiply everything by the numerator what? LCM. After multiplying everything by the numerator LCM, if there is square root in any of this complex number, we still have to multiply it by its what? Conjugate. Look at what I'm saying. You have a question like this. So, the numerator, which is this, the upper side of this equation, so we have the LCM here, which is what? We have x, root of x, and what? 2. So, like I said, the first thing you have to do is what? Multiply everything by the LCM. So, here is what? You're going to multiply, this is 2 root x, right? And then, this same place, you're going to multiply it by what? 2 root what? X. Now, if 2 root x comes inside this place, 2 root x times 1 over root x, this will cancel this, right? So, this x will cancel this x, so you have what? 2. If this comes into this and times it, 2 will cancel 2, so you have what? Root of x all over. So here, I normally advise my students, do not expand it, because what we are trying to do is what? Cancel out. So you have a denominator of what? X minus 4, and then you have another one of what? 2 root of x, right? Good. And remember, please, remember to always be putting your limit at x is equal to what? 4. Now, the next thing, the next law is whenever there is square root, multiply the top and the bottom by its what? Its conjugate. Conjugate simply means, for example, if you have a plus root b all over 3, and I say multiply everything by its conjugate, let me say 3 minus a and b, for example. And I say multiply it by its conjugate. It just simply means that this a, it will be what? A minus, you just change the sign here, a minus what would be all over what? A minus would be. So we are tying it by what? Conjugate. Under this value, you have 2 minus x. So the conjugate here will be what? 2 plus what? Root what? X. All over what? 2 plus what? Root of what? X. Right? Good. Now, once you reach here, life is somehow what? Easier. The next thing is for you to what? Open up your bracket. 2 times 2 will give you what? 4. So please follow me. It's very simple. 2 times 2 will give you 4. Now, 2 times this will give you what? Plus 2 root of x. This times this will give you what? Minus 2 root of x. This times this will give you what? Minus 1 x. Because this times this will give you x squared. Root of x squared will give you what? X. Good. Now, divide everything by what? X minus 1. Do not touch it. 2 root of x. And then you have another one. What? 2 plus root of x. Right? Good. Then the next thing we're going to do is what? You can see that here that this will cancel out what? This. Right? So I'm going to be left out with 4 minus x all over x minus 4 into 2 root of x into what? 2 plus what? Root of x. Right? Now look at this thing. The purpose of me simplifying this is I want to find a value that I'm going to have to cancel out from the denominator. But you have x minus 4 here, and I have 4 minus x, so I can factor minus 1 outside to make this to look like this. If I factor minus 1 outside, so this will now come into what? Minus 1 into what? X minus 4. All into what? X minus 4. And 2 root of x. And what? 2 plus root of x. So from here, if you tie this thing, you're still going to get this thing, this same value, right? Good. So what you're going to do is, this will cancel this. So you'll be left with what? Minus 1 all over what? 2 root of x. Minus 1, 2 root of x, all into what? 2 plus what? Root of what? X. Right? Once you are here, remember we are still under limits. Limit of x is equal to what? 4. So all you have to do right now is substitute the value of x into this equation and your answer will flow naturally. Now, if you substitute the value, you have minus 1 all over 2 root of 4 into bracket 2 root of 4. So your answer is going to be minus 1 all over 1, 16. So this is the answer to this. Remember, I said something. Whenever you have a question like this, the very first thing you need to do is what? The LCM, multiply the top and bottom by it what? The LCM. The next rule is, whenever there is a square root in the complex number, use the conjugate to multiply what? Both sides. So the very first thing I did was to get the LCM. I wanted to turn the improper fraction to what? Proper fraction. So, the next thing is to what? Multiply it by what? It conjugate. And if you are very good in solve, all you need to do is what? Multiply out. Once you multiply out, the only thing that this cancel this. And then we are left with this. But you can see that this resembles this. So I wanted to change this to this. That's why I factored out what? Minus 1. And that's why I cancel out. And you can see that how the answer came out naturally. Let me give you a more simple example right now so that you just scatter it. What if you have something like this? And if you have an example like this, you have limit of s is equal to 3, and then you have 1 all over x minus 1 all over 3, all into what? X minus 3. Now, for you to solve this limit, there is no root. But this is a complex number. So what are you going to do? You're going to have to multiply what? The top and the bottom by its what? Its LCM. Right? So here you have x and you have 3. So the LCM of this is what? You just times everything by what? 3x. Times here by what? 3x. So when 3x comes into this place, s will cancel s. So you're going to have to get what? 3. If 3 comes into this place, 3 will cancel 3. So you get what? X. So all over what? X minus 3 and what? You have 3x. Like I said, always leave the word, the denominator. Do not go and expand it. Now the next thing you can see that this thing resembles this, but we can make it to look exactly the same. What are we going to do? Pause the video, you're going to know what to do. What are you going to do? It's very simple. All you need to do is what? Factor out minus 1. Like I did in the other example. So you want to factor out minus 1. So whenever you factor out minus 1, you have what? X minus 3, right? All into what? X minus 3. And then what? 3x. So this will cancel this. Then you'll be left with what? Minus 1 into what? 3x. And remember, you have a limit of what? X is what? Is 3, right? So all I have to do is just insert the value of 3. So you'll be left with minus 1 all over 9. How simple can this be? It's very, very simple. Are you with me? Good. Now let's proceed into another one, another example. I wanted to get this very, very, very well. What if you had a limit? You had a limit. What if you have a limit value of root of x minus 3 all over x minus 9, and you have a limit of what? S is equal to what? 9. You can see that this is a what? A complex number. What are you going to do? It does not contain fraction, so we are not going to what? We are not going to times the top and the bottom by its LCM, but it contains roots. So what are we going to do? We're going to just times it by its what? Its conjugate. The conjugate is the side that contains the what? The root. So dicing this by its conjugate, so this is solution. So you have root of x minus 3 all over x minus 9 times the conjugate of the side that contains the root. So this is what? Root of x plus 3 all over what? Root of x plus what? 3. The next thing I'm going to do is what? The numerator, I'm going to what? Multiply it out. So if I multiply it out, I'm going to get this times this is x squared. Root of x squared should give me what? X. This times this will give you what? Plus 3 root of x. This times this should give you what? Minus 3 root of x. This times this should give you what? Minus 9. Right? So you can see that this will cancel this. So you have this is x minus 9 times root of x plus what? 3. The next thing is what? So you are left with x minus 9 all over x minus 9 into what? Root of x plus what? 3. Right? This will do what? Cancel this. Remember, our limit is what? X is at what? 9. So you'll be left with what? 1 all over root of x plus what? 3. So all you have to do now, you can see simplify, just insert the value wherever you see x, put 9. So you'll be left with 1 all over root of 9 plus 3. And root of 9 is what? Root of 9 should give you 3. So whenever you cross it together, you should get 1 all over what? 6. And that is the word, the answer. So please, let me revise the rule again. Whenever you have a square root under limit, you have to times it by the side that contains the square root using the word it conjugate. Whenever you have a fraction like this, what you have to do is what? The LCM. You have to times the top and the bottom by its what? Its LCM. That is the whole rule you need to know under this limit, under this part 1 video. We are going to meet under the part 2 video. Thank you very much.